okay.
It was no accident.
Go.
Me finding you.
No.
She was supposed to go by herself. He was supposed
Just go.
She thought he was going. She was going by herself. No. That's what we were telling him.
No.
Now I just can't
believe. Let me see if I get this right.
Ready?
If there's
you're in my
just witnessed was the a unity candle lighting ceremony. A lot of people might not understand exactly what that is, but let me kind of do a quick explanation. If you look at the table, this is what Danielle and Ryan's life has come to today. As you notice, the two outside candles, they represent the two families. The candles start full size, and even through, even though the candles grow shorter over time, the flames, and the glow will never diminish. The families that are contributed to Danielle and Ryan's individual characters, which drew them together, like never diminishing family flame, the love and respect the couple has for family will never diminish. However, the dependence on family will continue to grow a little less because it is now Ryan and Danielle's turn to start their own family flame. Genesis 2:24 and Ephesians 5:31 says, a man leaves his father and mother and embraces his wife, not yet, embraces his wife. They become one flesh. And the footnote on the next verse says, and this is an exciting one for them, the two of them, the man and wife, were naked, but they felt no shame. Okay. And then now we go to the next two candles. They represent Danielle and Ryan and the respective family that was lit by the family's candle. The children's candle are taller than the family's candle because they are just starting out with their own families. Over time, the candle grows shorter and the flame will still be as bright as it is today. The purple candle that is behind the unity candle represents the Holy Trinity. The couple agrees together that Christ should be a part of the new family. That God has given the position of the head of household to the husband. So after agreement with the wife, it is the responsibility of the husband to give the nod of the Trinity candle to be part of lighting the unity candle. The unity candle represents the two becoming one, but for the candle to withstand any strain in their marriage, inviting the third party, which is Christ, to be part of the marriage, it just increases the strength. Like three strands of rope is always stronger than just a two-stranded rope. Because of free will, Christ never forces himself and is never pushy, but will immediately be there when asked. If you notice, all six candles will remain brightly lit. This represents that the family support will always be there. Ryan and Danielle's candle will still burn because it represents the individual traits and characteristics that drew them together and will continue to grow individually, but would continue to glow as the candle does. The unity candle is properly protected, will withstand any sorts of storm of life that comes around. And yes, there will be occasional storms and sometimes typhoons. Of course, the Trinity candle has always been around from the beginning of time, will never go out, and it will always be there to help the unity flame whenever it starts to flicker or diminish. At this time, let's just say a brief prayer. Gentlemen, please remove your hats. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for being you. Thank you so much for giving us all that humorous bone, the sense of humor that we can have during this serious time. And Lord, we just ask that you be with us and be with the families represented in here. And this will probably be the last prayer given before these two are become one. We ask this in your name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. As we begin this afternoon, the sacred ceremony, I would like to give just a little bit of background on where the vows originated from and how they got started. The structure of marriage was given to the first couple on earth when they left the Garden of Eden. It wasn't before they left, it was after they left. Hey, this is what it's going to be like. Real quick, Genesis 2, 21 and 22. It starts out that God put man in a deep sleep. As he slept, he removed one of the ribs, replaced it with flesh. God then took the rib and formed from the man to make a woman and presented her to man. And all the man could think of was hubba hubba. Though that's my version, sorry. Then he regained his composure. The man said, finally, bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. Named her woman, for she was made from man. Therefore, the man leaves his father and mother, embraces his wife, and they become one. Genesis 3:6 is where we start seeing the structure of marriage. When the woman saw the tree, it was like good eating, and realized that what she could get out of it. She'd know everything, the tree of knowledge. She ate the fruit, and her husband was standing there. Adam was right there, so he gave it to her and to him, and he ate. Well, Adam was with Eve when the world went sideways. Adam, being with Eve, didn't stop his wife from picking that fruit to start with. Then she stood, she took a bite, shared with him, who also ate from the fruit. Adam should have had this first intervention session ever in a loving way to remind her what God told them about the tree. So Eve really got somewhat the full anger of history and every mother during childbirthing for picking the fruit and taking the first bite. Adam would have saved her a lot of historical shame if he would just enforce the rules set by God. So in Genesis 3:16 to 19, God told the woman, "I multiply your pains in childbirth. You'll give birth to your babies in pain. Look forward to this. You'll want to please your husband, but he'll lord over you." And then God told man, "Because you listened to your wife and ate from the tree, and I commanded you not to, don't eat from this tree. The very ground is cursed because of you. Getting food from the ground will be painful as having babies as be for your wife. You'll be working in pain all your life long. The ground will sprout thorns, weeds. You'll get your food from the hard way, planting and tilling and harvesting, sweating in the fields from dusk to dawn till you return to the ground yourself, dead, buried. As you started out as dirt, you'll end up as dirt." Just think of it. All this because Adam didn't man up or husband up at the time to tell Eve, "Wait, don't do that." So anyway, the traditional vows that we hear that is usually given during a wedding ceremony is from Scripture. And like in Genesis, God gave a talking to Eve before Adam. But likewise, in the following Scripture, the direction of the wife comes before the husband's. In 1 Peter 3, 1 through 7, Danielle, "Be a good wife to Ryan, responsive to his needs. There are husbands who, indifferently as they are to any words about God, will be captivated by your life of holy beauty. What matters is not your outer appearance, the styling of your hair, the jewelry that you wear, the cut of your clothes, but your inner disposition. Cultivate inner beauty, the gentle, gracious kind that God delights in. The holy women of old were beautiful before God, and that way they were good, loyal wives to their husbands. Sarah, for instance, taking care of Abraham, would address him as my dear husband. You'll be true daughters of Sarah if you do the same, unanxious, unintimidated. You'll be true, and Ryan, the same goes for you as Danielle's husband. Be a good husband to Danielle. Honor her, delight in her. As a woman, she will lack some of your advantages as a man, but in your new life and God's grace, you're equals. Treat Danielle, then, as equal so your prayers won't run aground." That was 1 Peter. And then in Ephesians, the instructions for households is submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. "Danielle, submit yourself to Ryan as you do the Lord, for Ryan will be the head of you as Christ is the head of the church. With Christ's body, for which he was Savior, now the church submits to Christ, so Danielle submits to Ryan in everything. Ryan, love Danielle just as Christ loves the church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by washing it with water and through word to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any blemish, but holy and blameless. In this way, Ryan, you ought to love Danielle as your own body. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one's ever hated their own body, but they feed and care for their body, just as Christ does the church, for we are all members of this body." And some bodies are bigger than others. I saw that. For this reason, a man will leave his father and be united with his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a repeat from Old Testament. The profound mystery, I am talking to you about Christ and the church. However, Ryan, you must love Danielle as yourself, and Danielle, you must respect your husband, Ryan. Summing this up, back to 1 Peter. And this is for everybody to consider in your daily walk and as you deal with a new family that's being started. Be agreeable, sympathetic, loving, compassionate, humble. And no exceptions, no retaliations, no sharp-tongued sarcasm. Instead, bless. And that's everyone's job, is to bless. You'll be a blessing, and you'll always get back a blessing. Say nothing evil or hurtful. Snub the evil and cultivate good. Run after peace for everything that you're worth. God looks on with his approval, listening and responding well to what he's asked, but he turns his back on things that are done evilly. Okay, now, as we get into the vows, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of all these witnesses to join together Ryan and Danielle in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God in the innocence of Eden, symbolizing the mystical union between Christ and his church, the holy estate Christ adorned and sacrificed with his presence, the first miracle that he performed in Cana of Galilee. If you remember, the first miracle was before the first miracle was supposed to start. It was his mom, Jesus' mama, saying, "Hey, we ran out of wine. Jesus, do something." He goes, "Mom, it's not my time yet." But what did he do? He followed mama's orders and went ahead, and they flourished in the wine. And everybody wondered why the best wine was brought out last. Okay? So this is something that is historical in the life of Christ with the very first miracle. The writer to the Hebrews commented that being honorable among all people, it is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. In his holy estate, these persons present now come to be joined. Ryan and Danielle, I require and charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that the commitment to marriage is a commitment to permanence. It is the intent of God that your marriage will be for life, and that only death will separate you. One of your best examples is Grandma and Grandpa Thompson. Just shy of 50 years married until Grandma's passing. Death did they part. If the vows you exchange today be kept without violation, and if you seek always to know and to do the will of God, your life will be blessed. His presence in your home will abide in peace. Ryan, y'all turn it over. Ryan, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love, comfort, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, to include COVID-19, 20, 21, 22, and all the sequential numbers that will come up, and forsaking others, keeping yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live? If so, answer I will. You do. That's right.
We didn't hear you back here.
I do. He does. Okay. Danielle, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love, comfort, honor, and keep him in health and in sickness, to include COVID-19, 20, 21, 22, and any of the other sequential numbers that come up, forsaking all others, keeping yourself only to him as long as you both shall live? Will you answer? You do. Well, I would, but I think he's taken. Now, to the congregation, one more time. As parents, families, friends, and members of God's family, will you give your blessings to the union? And if you answer, please say, "You will."
We will.
We will. Yeah.
There we go. Now, you got a support group right there. You got a support group up here. You got a support group to your sides. You got a support group up here if you can't find nobody. Now, there's no reason, okay? You catch somebody, you call them, even if you don't have cell service here, you get to who you can and get a hold of somebody, okay? This will work, and I know it will. I know you two. I've got to meet you, and you guys are great. You're great for each other. You're great for my family. Thank you. You don't know what you're getting into, but thank you.
Rick, you're not supposed to tell him that.
I don't want to surprise him. This is his last second that he can. Anyway. Okay. Repeat after me. I, Ryan Abney.
I, Ryan Abney.
Thank you, Danielle Thompson.
Thank you, Danielle Thompson.
To be my wedded wife. To have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, or poorer, in sickness to include all the COVIDs. In health, to love and cherish until death do you part, according to God's holy ordinance and thereto I pledge you my faith. Okay, Danielle. I, Danielle Thompson. Thank you, Ryan Abney.
Thank you, Ryan Abney.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, or poorer.
For richer, or poorer.
In sickness to include all the COVIDs.
In sickness to include all the COVIDs.
And in health.
And in health.
To love and cherish.
To love and cherish.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And
thereto I pledge you my faith.
And thereto I pledge you my faith.
Are there rings?
Yes.
Well, we're here to tie the knot, but he untied the knot. I don't know what that means, but okay. Okay. Grandpa. Now, be it for me. With this ring, I give you as a token of my love and as a pledge of my constant fidelity. Eternal Father, Creator, Preserver of all, Giver of all spiritual graces, Author of everlasting life, send your blessing upon these, your servants, Ryan and Danielle, whom you now bless in your name, so they will keep the vow and covenant made between them this hour, and may ever remain in love and peace together through Jesus Christ our Lord. For as much as this man and this woman have consented together in holy wedlock, and to have witnessed the same before God in this company, and have declared the same by joining of hands, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, to whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully will look favorably upon you and fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace. May you so live together in this life, in the world, that you come, that you may have life everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, now, Ryan patiently waited for this for about an hour. I don't know before then, but I haven't seen you most of the morning. Ryan, you may now kiss your wife. And everybody says, yee-haw!
Yee-haw!
Woo!
Woo!
Look at power vested in me by the church and the Missouri State Gaming Commission. Oh, too much Vegas vacation, sorry. I mean the state of Missouri. I present to you now Mr. and Mrs. Ryan and Danielle Abney. And then y'all just the whole way.
No, it was Matt said he wanted at least a hand.
Oh, I don't think I can take that one.
You got my notes. When people come to come right away.
When you get married.
Shit, I hope I don't get married.
There is reception downstairs. There is also a box.
Hey, which you want a picture to go?
Oh, my bad.
For cards, and one is for the honeymoon. Honeymoon cash.
You go with him, and then you get your picture taken.
It was no accident, me finding you. Someone had a hand in it long before we ever knew. Now I just can't believe you're in my life. Heaven's smiling down on me as I look at you tonight. I tip my hand stars. He sure knew what he was doing when he joined these two hearts. I hold everything when I hold you in my arms, and I've got all soft moonlight on your face. Oh, how you shine. It takes my breath away just to look into your eyes. I know I don't deserve